Lillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember? I'll find him.
What's that?
Don't touch the walls.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
I can hear him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist.
Where can you go? You're failing. Find
the flames I passed through were real enough. Down the northman to hell.
You don't recognize it. Don't doubt yourself. You'll never find it. She doesn't recognize it.
Yes, you do. You know where you are.
She doesn't.
Listen for his voice. Listen.
Dillian, where
listen
are you?
Listen for his voice.
Does everything look the same?
Different.
There's a clue.
Light the torch.
Light it.
Look for the torch. Light it.
It'll help you.
Can you see?
It'll help you see.
Where are we?
She has no idea.
We're going down. You have fallen.
You think that sound is still him? It's not Dillian.
Find a way. There has to be a way.
Find a way.
There's always a way.
Don't stop now. Don't give up. You'll find a way.
You're too close to stop.
It's in there.
Father? I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief fencer.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the wall. As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it. This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong.
There he is.
Didius.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in. He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
It's a test.
It's just a trial.
Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it.
Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
You have to find Dillian. Now you have to find him.
Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm.
We found a way to climb the tower, the ladder.
Quick. What now?
You can see it. A line to the truth.
Come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there?
Find him. You have to find
come out
him.
If you are.
There was a Northman called Grettir. Big, red-haired, immensely strong. But he was afraid of the dark. It happened one night that an undead creature came to his house to drag him out.
Move away. Move away. Feel it. You'll die. You're lost.
Two more rooms.
You have to find them.
Where are you? You're lost.
Where are they?
The light. Go towards it. Find
focus.
Us.
Focus.
Focus.
Look.
One more to find. One more.
One down, send.
Find the other symbol. You're lost.
Where is he?
Where are you?
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong? Do with the sword.
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours. What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
It's just a pointless guess. You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again. You don't know. It's just their game for you. You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things.